Pavel Datsyuk.
Datsyuk in on goal, and he does it again!
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Oh, my God. You know, the minute you see Pavel Datsyuk, you marvel at his skill level.
Here's Datsyuk, cuts back, Datsyuk shoots, scores!
Datsyuk has the ability to not only see what's in front of him, but what's coming from behind him.
Datsyuk, a beautiful move, set up for the score!
Incredible ability to handle the puck and change directions and speeds is dumbfounding.
Pavel Datsyuk dangles from the blue line in.
I think players that play against him now know you can't run him. You're just going to bounce off of him. Once or twice a game, he would just go through the entire team.
You know, I grew up playing hockey. My father's Bobby Hull. Where does this guy grow up and learn to do these things?
Datsyuk in the clear all alone! Oh, what a goal! Oh, put that in your highlight reel, Bank!
Jaromir Jagr.
He was like a Mario, only left-handed shot Mario.
He was a monster physically.
There was so much pure strength to his game that it was literally unstoppable.
Jagr on the right wing, hooked from behind. Leonard Parents by McLean, but he gets to the net! Jagr scores!
He's a lot like Lemieux in the sense that their skill was that of a guy who was 6 feet, but the fact they were 6'4", 6'4½", they had that extra reach.
He didn't really impress you with his stick handling, but all of a sudden you'd see him, you know, stick handle around three guys and score a goal.
Jagr moving, Jagr, look at the move. Again, Jagr in, Jagr scores!
The puck would be, you know, 15 feet on this side of the body, and the next thing you know, it's 15 feet on the other side of the body.
Jagr moves in with speed. Jagr to the net. He scores!
Jagr playing it back inside his feet. Goes around, shot. Oh! What a play by Jagr!
The goal that really stands out for Jaromir Jagr is in the 92 Stanley Cup Final.
Jagr intercepted.
He ended up putting it through Brent Sutter's feet.
Hangs on to it.
Then he went in and he deked two or three more guys.
He makes some really good players look pretty bad.
And a good move, another good move. He's in, scores! What a goal! Jagr! Oh my!
Just a phenomenal player.
Pavel Bure.
Very dynamic with his speed.
His speed. He's like a predator.
Bure against Hatcher, trying to go around the defenseman. He does. He scores. Ridley for Bure. Pavel Bure in for a shot. He scores.
He was the type of player that could electrify the fans every time he touched the puck.
Nemestikov throws a pick, and Bure is burnt loose and scores. What a goal, Pavel Bure.
When he turned the corner on you or decided he was gone, adios.
Brown, a hit for Bure.
Every time he touched the puck, the crowd was electric.
Bure works back to the point, still controlling it, moving into the slot, trying to go to his forehand, he scores! What a great move by Pavel Bure!
He tried different things that guys have never tried before.
Pavel Bure, shorthanded breakaway, score! Now we're all going to want to watch this replay.
It's those types of things that other people watch and learn from.
Exciting player to watch.
Denny Savard.
He was like a little water bug, you know, almost, he was like a garden hose.
Makes the move, spins around, continues, Devlin stays with him.
He was like a water bug, he was quick.
Brown loves it, Savard moves around in front, score!
The spinorama he did, was a natural thing to do.
He'd get it on his stick, and you could just hear everybody just go, phew. They were all excited, because something great might happen.
Skates through center. Dragging the puck.
Kevin tries to put his stick down, and Savard just puts it underneath him.
Around Tegan, around Walsh, it scores! What a goal by Dennis Savard!
I can remember jumping over the boards, watching the last 15 seconds of it in amazement.
Kent Nielsen.
Skill-wise, he might have been the most skilled hockey player I ever saw in my entire career.
My favorite line from my father was, Kent Nielsen can stop on a dime and give you change. So he had unbelievable skills.
He had a dimension to him that's hard to find in the game today.
Because Kent had sheer speed and quick hands and stick handling. Probably one of the most talented guys that I've ever seen dance with a puck.
He could do things with the puck at a speed that other guys couldn't quite do in that day and era.
Puck skill, shot, size, When he wanted the puck, it was his puck.
A couple of sequences stand out. He was challenged by the producer, you've heard the story, to see if he could hit a crossbar from center ice, and there were five pucks, and he hit it with the first puck and skated off the ice.
Aiming for the crossbar. I don't want to put any extra pressure on, but he is ready.
Gilbert Perreault.
The thing about Perreault was he had that speed, that extra gear that not a lot of guys had.
He was an amazing, amazing hockey player, big and strong, and sort of like Mario Lemieux before there was Mario Lemieux. Like, his goals were just highlight reel goals.
Kind of a mixture of a Savard and a Bure. You know, he was such a great skater, way ahead of his time as a great skater, like a Bobby Orr, but he had some slick moves like Denny Savard did as well, and that's he was one of my favorite players growing up.
Perreault was one of those electrifying players where he took the puck from, you know, behind the net, and when he started to go, he was shifty, wind up, he could basically go through the whole team and score a pretty goal.
A lot of defensemen were caught swimming across the ice trying to get to him because he just dragged it forever, and they think they have him, and they just can't get to him, and he just had great lateral movement.
He had the great moves, and he could go from side to side, but because of those bow legs, I think it gave him the opportunity to sidle left or right, almost at a whim.
The speed. The way he could attack with speed and the bow legs and just his strength on the puck and how he can make things happen. He would turn defensemen so easily because he could accelerate from a standing still position. Just an amazingly gifted player.
Alex Kovalev.
Kovalev, just a magician with the puck.
The most talented player I ever played with, bar none. I can't even think anybody close.
Here's Kovalev, the number 8. Great move there. Walks in. Backhander. Shoots and scores.
He was the one guy that probably, skill-wise, could go through an entire team, go back, and then go do it again.
Incredible skill. That man could do things that I had never seen before.
Up there with Vladimir Vutek, 19. Kovalev still on it. Look at him make that move around Dan. And Kovalev fires and scores. What a play by Alexei Kovalev.
Probably the best hands, you know, just to do tricks and to play and do a one-on-one after practice.
He's one of those guys in practice, you watch the things that he does. One-on-one, he had tremendous abilities.
3-on-2 across the line, Kovalev fakes, nice move on Kasperainen, scores!
A really elusive player. He could control the puck in real tight quarters, a very, very powerful man.
Here's Kovalev shooting, he scores! Alexei Kovalev will rock it over the right shoulder of Grant Fuhr.
Boy, can he stick handle, and then when he decides he's just going to let that wrist shot go, he can fire it with the best of them, but he's got some sweet hands, I'll tell you that.
Wayne Gretzky.
He was born to be the greatest player that ever played the game.
He is the most elite skilled player that the game has had to this point.
What made me a player that I was to rely on my speed and my intelligence.
He's the worst stick in hockey, and he had one of the best shots in hockey.
I think one of the things in my career that I was a little bit underrated at was that, you know, if there was a loose puck, I was going to get to it.
Breakaway pass to Gretzky. Greg Levy trying to catch him. Can't! Gretzky scores!
You couldn't just watch Gretzky. You had to know what was going on all over the ice. So if Curry was over here behind you, you had to know that or you were toast.
He'd throw a pass across the ice to nobody. There's nobody there except Jari Kurri would be coming, and boom, it's right on the tape.
You could argue whether or not you were as fast or as strong or your shot was as hard, and yet he was just a pure genius on the ice.
He looked at the puck in the air, looked around at the net, spun around in the air, and batted the puck.
Blocked and up in the air. Gretzky scores!
Into the top corner of the net. After having seen the puck up in the air, looking to check where the net was, spinning around and banging it in the net. I mean, it's just something you just smile and you shake your head.
He would see people and find people on the ice that nobody else would see. And you wouldn't even know that they're open till he would deliver the puck there.
Nobody saw the ice better than Gretzky.
His vision was remarkable.
I really just followed Bobby Clark and patterned myself after what he did, and that's how I started playing behind the net. My rest of my career was played a lot, you know, from the corners and from behind the net.
We were in Montreal. It was in overtime, and I went in front of the net, and he was behind the net. He was the player that was the most patient behind the net, and I literally looked at him, and I said, wait. Like, I gave him the finger up,
I went all the way outside the zone, outside the blue line. I came right back down the middle, and he waited till I came all the way back. He gave it to me. I put it in the net, and it was overtime. We were in the locker room. I never forgot that, because what player would actually have the presence to see the other dummy going, yeah, wait for me, I'll be right back.
It was like a chess master that, you know, you might know how to play chess, and you might know how to move the pawn like I know how to move the pawn, but I know what's going to happen 15 moves ahead, and you only know what's going to happen one move ahead.
I think genius is the perfect word for it.
Bobby Orr.
He's over the line, and he's going deep on Lysiak, and he goes behind the net, has it open, it's done! Bobby Orr!
Getting daylight up through center ice. Walking in, shot kicked out, another shot. Great set, goal!
Just an incredible, talented player that changed your game. For the defenseman from that position, being able to dominate the game like he did from the back end like he did was just phenomenal.
He revolutionized the game because he was so far superior in all the skill levels that any other D at that time had.
Bobby Orr's got it as he's doing a bit of fancy stick handling between the two blue lines.
Just sitting on the bench and watching this guy dominate on the ice. I mean, he could take his speed to whatever level he had to be faster than the guy trying to chase him.
To try to penetrate. Harris, he does. He's in. He cuts in front. He scores!
Such a nice, fluent way that he played end-to-end rushes, and so talented, could skate like the wind.
Well, the fact that he revolutionized the position is just remarkable to me. And you look at those old highlights when he was at his best. Just to go from a start, make a play, get back to position like he could. I mean, he was the first to do it.
Mario Lemieux.
I think if there's one guy that you can put together an extended reel of just magnificent goals, it's Mario Lemieux.
Mario was a lot like Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan wanted the ball, Mario Lemieux wanted the puck. And when you got in the puck, he made special things happen.
Here's Lemieux. The center penalty coming up. Look at Lemieux!
He was so skilled. I knew skilled players that marveled at Mario.
Big guy, strong, quick release, had a great shot. He had probably the most skilled guy I ever seen or played with or against.
Lemieux, he shoots, he scores! Mario Lemieux!
He had his two moves. Give him top glove, he's going to put it there, and he's going to put it right. He's going to put it right where he should, or he's going to bring it over here. He was one-on-one, he was no question the toughest guy to defend as a goal.
He was the first sort of big man to be able to combine that reach and size with finesse that a guy who's only 6 feet tall could have, and he was pretty special.
He just had all the skills in the world. And then to boot, he was 6'6" and strong as an ox.
He shoots and scores! Mario Lemieux!
Mario and I were really similar, probably more similar than any other player that I played with or against in my career. Not only how we handled the puck, but how we saw the ice. The difference was his reach.
Look out here. He shoots one. That's in! Lemieux has scored!
Skill-wise, yeah, could be the best player, best talent to ever play the game.
His skill was indisputable. The fact that he had that size to go with it. I mean, you could be on his left hip trying to check him, and the puck's 4 feet away. Like, you just can't get it.
Breakaway chance for Mario Lemieux. In on goal. He shoots and scores!
I'm coming up the ice, I'm coming right at you, and I'm going to go right through you and around you, and you can't stop me.
He could really, really make you look bad one-on-one.
Mario Lemieux coming to center, trying to fool Bork, and does! Look out! Scores!
I don't know what I was doing on that. That was, whenever I see that, I just turn away or walk away, because that was really embarrassing.
He put the puck in the skates of Captain Ray Bork.
I don't know if he was going left or right, and it was comical. It's comical to watch.
To play with Ray every day is to know how good Ray was. And he was so special, and that's when I talked about the ability to do something one-on-one to a person that's almost incomprehensible.
Have you ever seen such finesse?
Guys on the bench I can still remember them staying on the bench. That was unbelievable. He's our teammate. And all Samuelson looked back at me and said, that was off the charts.